All right, I was talking with somebody here recently about a 25-level if statement that I wrote about 10 years ago. It works. It still works. The people are still using that application. So relax. If you still write a lot of if statements that are nested, it's okay if they work. But I started thinking about how could it be more efficient? What was the challenge? We had to identify any overlapping times. Here we have somebody who's had to write down the start and end times and tasks that they did. And the employer wanted to make sure that none of these times overlapped. This challenge would be easy if we could force people to put their time in order. But no, what happens? Somebody's at the end of the day and they've input a bunch of times and then they say, oh yeah, 4 hours ago I did that thing and that was at 1 p.m. to 1:30 and they put it in there. They need to know if that overlapped with something else. But if we were to force people to put the times in order, that is when you cause a rebellion. You don't want rebellions and mutinies. All right, let's figure this out. I'm going to use SUMPRODUCT equals SUMPRODUCT. We've got the SUMPRODUCT parentheses open. We need another parentheses because we're going to use two criteria. So I'm going to open another set of parentheses. And we want where this C4 of that start time is less than or equal to any of the end times. Close parentheses, multiplication, open parentheses for the next criteria. Now we want to know if the end time is greater than or equal any of the start times. End time, need another close bracket, greater than or equal to any of the start times. Close parentheses, enter. SUMPRODUCT is telling us anywhere where we have something other than one, there is an overlap. So we look in rows 2 and 7. In row 2, we ended at 10:40, but then in row 7, we say we started a different task at 10:35. There's a 5-minute overlap. So if I go and say we started at 10:45, let's see, 10:45 a.m., everything's cool. But now we got to check this for different scenarios. Let's check in case the start and end times are fully within an existing time frame. Let's say we started something at 9:15 a.m. and went to 9:30 a.m. Good. It let us know we've got an overlap. And what if we put in a time range that's exactly like one that's already in the list? 2:15 p.m. to 2:45 p.m. Yep, we got an overlap. And one other thing we can do to help us out is add some conditional formatting. I'm going to highlight this range. Conditional formatting, new rule. Use a formula equals $F4 greater than 1. And what do I want it to do? I want it to do a fill. That's like this, this hot pink. Okay, okay. Now it's obvious where we have overlaps. So let's see about fixing this. This one was a duplicate, remove this row. And then we get this corrected. This was 9:30 a.m. This started at 9:45 a.m. Then this ended at 10:40 a.m. And the task was more C8. There you go. SUMPRODUCT to help you identify overlapping times and avoid rebellion. All right? See you in the next video.